Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this tutorial, I'm going to give you 6 tips for using masks in Photoshop. If you've used Photoshop for any amount of time, you know the importance of masks. They are a black and white image that dictates the transparency of your layer, and they open the door to so many creative possibilities in Photoshop. And in this quick tutorial, I'm going to give you 6 tips that you probably didn't know about using masks in Photoshop. All right, let's go to File, Open, and I'm going to open this Masks new PSD, which you should have gotten in the assets for this tutorial. The first tip I want to show you is how to create a shortcut for making a mask. If you've used Photoshop for any amount of time, you'll know that there is no shortcut for making masks. And if you're someone like me who really likes efficiency and getting to the fastest way of doing something, you're going to want a shortcut for this. So generally, when you're creating a mask in Photoshop, you're going to start with a selection and then click on the mask icon or layer icon down here. So let's go ahead and load a selection. I'm going to go load selection, and then in this file we have the bird selection. Let's hit OK. So here we go. We now have our bird selected. In order to make a mask, you would click on this mask icon. I'm going to undo that. The other way is to go up to your layer menu up here and then go to layer mask and then reveal selection. Now you'll notice none of these have shortcuts, but that's the other way of creating a layer mask. Now there I've shown you the 2 ways that aren't through some select and mask method. So what we want to do is we want to assign a shortcut to this menu item, reveal selection. Now fortunately, Photoshop allows you to customize your keyboard shortcuts. So we're going to go into keyboard shortcuts here. And if we go down here and open the layer, because that's where it is up in the menu, and then go down, we should arrive at layer mask. And we want the shortcut for reveal selection. And I'm using a Mac, but on a PC, just switch out the command for control and the option for alt. So I'm going to do shift option command M. And that's currently assigned to edit menus. Edit menus is something that you're really only going to use maybe once every year when you install the new version of Photoshop. Beyond that, you're not going to be editing your menus very often. So I don't care that this is I don't care that I'm stealing this shortcut from this because I never use it. And I want my primary shortcut to have M in it so I don't forget M for mask. So let's hit accept. The other one that you might want to have a shortcut for is hide selection. So this essentially does the same thing as holding option when you click on the layer mask icon, in that it inverts your selection before making the mask. So for that, because it's related to invert, I'm going to do shift option command I for invert. Now that's used for file info. Again, something that you never really need to use in any individual project in Photoshop, but creating masks is something that you'll use in almost every one. So having these shortcuts is great. Let's hit accept and then hit OK. Now I'm going to go ahead and delete this layer mask and reload my selection. And now what I can do is hold shift option command M, and voila, I have a mask. And this is great because now as I'm working in Photoshop, I don't need to go down here every time. I can just use my shortcut. So that's tip number 1. All right, tip number 2 is when you drag a mask in your layer channel to a different layer, if you hold down shift, you can actually invert the mask as you do it. So let's look at an example of this. I'm going to take my background and I'm going to put it above the archway. So now I need this same mask applied to my background, but I also need it inverted. If I just take the mask and drag it, you can see the problem it's creating. It's showing me the part of the sky that I don't want shown. So I could invert the mask by selecting it, then doing Command I to invert, but that's a lot of steps that we don't really need to do. So instead, I'm going to show you, if you hold down Shift, voila, it's inverted the mask. Now if I drag this back up here, just hold down Shift as I drag it, and you can see it inverts the mask as it applies it to your new layer. Now this also works if you hold down Option, which copies the mask from one layer to another. So if I'm holding down Option and I drag this, it'll copy the layer. But if I hold down Option and hold down Shift as well, it'll drag the layer or copy the mask, but also invert it when it copies it. So that's the trick. Hold down Shift when you're dragging layers if you want to invert them as you move them or copy them. Okay, tip number three is to know and understand your mask shortcuts. So what are your mask shortcuts? Your mask shortcuts are the shortcuts you can use when you click on the mask icon itself. So the first one you should know is just holding down Shift. That'll disable your mask and re-enable it. So that works as a toggle. And you'll see this red X. This is a great way if you're working on something and you want to see what it looks like without the mask. You just hold down Shift and click on the mask thumbnail, and that'll disable it or re-enable it. Okay, next is holding down Option. And what that does is it shows you your mask. So there you can see your mask. And this just gives you an easy visual representation at full size. You can zoom in here. You can use this if you're making some changes or want to look at if there's any white spots in your mask that you don't want. So again, that's just holding down Option or Alt on a PC and clicking on the mask. Okay, next is holding down Shift and Option at the same time. And what this does is it gives you a red overlay of your mask. So kind of a mix between the two. It's showing you the mask, but still showing you your image as well. And again, that works as a toggle. Just do it again and it'll turn off. Okay, then the last one is holding down Command or Control on a PC. And if you click on the thumbnail, it will load your selection. Now, when you have your selection loaded, the Shift and the Option behavior changes a little bit for your next one. If you want to add a selection, what you're going to do is hold down Command and Shift, and that'll add the selection. You can see my little icon is changing to include the plus symbol when I add the Shift. If I do it with Option, it'll subtract the selection. And if I hold both of them, Shift and Option, it'll intersect the selection. So those are your shortcuts for your mask. Very valuable to know because you'll be using them a lot in Photoshop. All right, the next tip I want to show you is how you can save a mask as a selection for later use. First, I'm just going to go ahead and delete this layer mask. In order to do that, what you can do is just select the layer mask itself and hit delete on your keyboard. Okay, so in order to save a mask as a selection, what you're going to do is select your layer or your mask, go to your channels, and you'll notice that you have a channel for your mask. Just take that and drag it to the new channel. Then you can change the name of it. Let's say Archway Selection. And now if we go back to our RGB here, and let's go ahead and delete this layer mask. And now what I want to do is I want to load it. Unfortunately, I don't have the mask anymore, but I do have my channel. So I can either load this by holding down Command and clicking on this thumbnail, or I can go to Select, Load Selection, and in my dropdown, you'll see my Archway Selection. I can hit OK there and then use my shortcut Shift Option Command M to add that mask. So that's another trick in terms of using masks, is you can load them as selections for later use. That way you don't have masks hanging around that you don't need in your file. Okay, tip number five is how to toggle between your mask and your layer mask without having to use your mouse. And the simple trick for that is Command slash or backslash in order to select your mask, and then Command 2 to select your layer. So Command backslash and then Command 2. That's a real quick, simple trick there. And then the last tip that I want to show you is how to add two masks to one layer. And the simplicity of this is what you're going to do. So here's a good example. I have a mask on my birds, but I also want the birds to be behind the archway. Now, I could obviously just move this layer to down here, but I want to do it with a mask so that this layer in my layer palette sits on top. So the problem is, if I take my archway mask here and drag this up and replace it, now I've lost my original mask. So I've masked out what I wanted, but I've also lost my original mask. I could also command click on my mask here to load the selection, and then on this mask paint out in black. So like this, I just filled my selection there with black, and now it's painted out. The problem here is if I move this, I've now lost the selections that I made. So I'm going to go back all the way until I don't have that anymore. And I'm going to show you a better trick so that you can have two active masks on one layer. Simplicity of this is put this layer into a group with Command G, and then take this and just make a copy. I'm actually going to hold down Shift as I make the copies to invert it. And there you can see I now have two masks, and both of them are just masking this one layer. And the beauty of this is I can take my birds layer, move it around, and now it's respecting the window, but I'm not losing any of my birds. So that's another trick there. In order to give two masks to a single layer, just put your layer in a group, and then you can apply masks to the group. Now this actually works even at a more like a nested level, meaning I could put another group on here, another mask, and actually have a third mask applying to this one single layer. So that's just a trick. If you want to apply more than one mask to a layer, you can group it and then apply a mask to the group. So there you have it. Those are six tips for using masks in Photoshop. And I'd love to hear from you which of these you didn't already know. So leave a comment on that. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel, leave a like, turn on notifications, share this video. Here are some other tutorials that you can check out. And if you enjoy these, you can also go to Nucly.com, where I have more professional courses and training on Photoshop and compositing and creating depth, as well as a bunch of Photoshop tools and presets that you may find valuable. All right, I'll see you next time.